If you like my videos, please check out my website at creationsciencefiction.com. You'll find articles on creationism there, as well as my blog. I also have a Creation Science Fiction Facebook page now, too.
Good evening, folks. Kent Hovind here and the crew at Dinosaur Adventureland in the roaring metropolis of Lenox, Alabama.
I got notification today that Kent Hovind responded to some of my videos. Now, I edited out the early part where he talks about day-to-day operations at Dinosaur Adventureland and asked people to send him money. So let's just go to the part where he starts talking about my videos.
Okay, interesting. Somebody sent me said, Brother Hovind, Bill Ludlow, that I debated some time ago, who claims he's an expert on cavemen, has his own website or YouTube channel. And he did one called Believing. This is just today. Is that right? Yeah.
7 hours ago.
April 16th.
7 hours ago.
A couple hours ago, yeah.
He's got a few of them. I just found them the other night, so I've been commenting on them.
Okay.
Well, the response to Kent's video on cavemen was uploaded 6 days ago. The one that he's really responding to now is just uploaded that day.
Believing Kent Hovind can be hazardous to your health.
That's why I'm going crazy.
Here's what it says. The snake oil salesman is at it again. I don't believe I've ever sold snake oil, Bill. I don't think I've ever actually seen any for sale either.
It's hard to say if Ken is just playing dumb or if he's really that ignorant. You know, a snake oil salesman is a common expression used for someone that sells, promotes, or is a general proponent of some valueless or fraudulent cure.
But anyway, pushing apricot seeds and vitamin B17 as a cure for cancer. Apricot seeds. I don't sell them. I eat them once in a while. They do not taste good. They look like they're from the middle of an apricot. It's organic. It's God made this, you know, and they don't taste real good. But anybody want to try some here? Pass those around, brother. Want to try some apricot seeds? They're like an almond for the first chew, and then you want to get something to chase it down. But they're not bad. Okay. What? Give one to Beans. I want to see Beans here. The dog.
You can hear his followers from the compound there in the background. Please don't give it to the dog. You know, dogs are a lot smaller and it takes a lot less apricot seeds to get them sick. Same thing goes with small children. Please don't give it to any small children there.
Anyway, Bill, it's really okay to eat the seeds from any fruit, okay? Any fruit, okay.
No, the fact is that seeds from a lot of fruit are actually poisonous, but you just keep chomping down on them, Kent.
He has a 20-minute commercial in the middle of his Man and Dinosaurs Together video. Here's some of the comments down there. I just saw this a little bit ago. I thought, you got to be kidding. Cyberwise writes in, Kent Hovind has no conscience, no ethics, as well as some obviously low moral standards. Where do you get any of that? Although that shouldn't come as a surprise, he is a creationist slash apologist, after all. It would be funny if he wasn't so dangerous. I don't think I'm dangerous. I haven't hit anybody since sophomore year in high school. And that's why this knuckle is lower than the rest of them.
Her name?
No, it wasn't her. And he needed it. And he got up and decided to leave me alone after that. Okay. Anyway, so no. This is great, Bill. These are great. Well overdue and well done, Agrippa says. Carl Dawkins, just because it contains cyanide does not mean it's poison. Professor Dr. Kent Hovind. Well, Carl, that is correct. Just because water contains hydrogen does not mean it's explosive either. I mean, it's simple chemistry 101. It's not complicated.
What he's doing here is he's addressing some of the comments on the latest video about him they uploaded. He's not addressing the video content at all.
Speak of the devil. Kent, are you aware that it's possible to debunk everything you've ever said just by going to the websites where all the published scientific literature can be found online and reading for a few hours? No, Aaron, I'm not aware of that. I'll tell you what, Aaron, why don't you schedule a debate and send the best evidence you know of for evolution, and we'll discuss it. And we'll post it right here on our channel, unedited.
You're going to see a pattern here. Instead of addressing these questions or comments or the content of my video, what he does is challenge everyone to a personal debate.
Maybe take out the coughs, since I have had this cough for like 30 years.
Isn't there a fruit or a seed or something for that?
John writes in, thanks for this video. I've seen a few Hovind debunking videos now. I keep hoping he will make a response to them. Not that they would do any good. I just want to see him squirm. Well, John, if you think I am wrong and would squirm over these debunking videos, which terrify me so madly, send your best evidence for evolution. Let's have the debate right here. Steve, we can do 3 or 4 a day, couldn't we, over there at the, yeah.
I couldn't leave in all the comments and responses, or this video would have been way too long, so don't be offended if you don't see yours.
What are you doing, on Skype or something?
24 hours in a day?
Yeah, I'll debate 3 or 4, all you followers, Bill, I'll debate at the same time, if I get half the time.
Tough
guy. And we discuss one topic at a time. That's all, simple rules. Joint Chief writes in, according to Hovind, lizards are actually dinosaurs. He isn't really a doctor. Well, Joint Chief, lizards never stop growing is what I say. And I show a picture of a chameleon and a three-horned chameleon and a three-horned triceratops and say, there seems to be some similarity. I don't claim the chameleon grew into the triceratops, but it may have. There's a lot of similarities. They have three horns. The triceratops is a giant lizard. I think that's what the dinosaur means, terrible lizard.
Kent's been corrected hundreds of times. Dinosaurs weren't lizards, and there's no way they could have lived long enough to become that large.
Timothy writes in, he's insanely stupid, or he practices really, really hard to be stupid. Well, Timothy, if you think I'm stupid, I should be an easy challenge in a debate. Bring it on, honey. Suzette, now he has a cure for cancer. Whoa, who needs a god, eh? Well, I think God provided the cure for many diseases in the food that we eat. Marcus, this is one of the many reasons I despise this man and his son. They peddle literal poison to the masses. Anybody get poisoned yet from eating the apricot seeds?
No.
They don't taste too good, though, do they?
No.
Okay. Hey, as they die, Rich, would you and who else? Nick, drag them out as they die here. It's a seed to a fruit, for heaven's sake. Gee whiz. Looking forward to the day when Eric shares a cell with his daddy, inmate number 0645201. James writes him, bad methods yield bad outcome, and since Kent exhibits really, really, really bad method, well, you can guess the result every time with everything he claims. Okay, James, show me. Be specific. All they do is make generic claims. He's wrong. He's wrong. He's a liar. He doesn't know anything.
There are specific claims and specific examples in the videos that I did, but I think Kent's afraid to address those.
This guy not only denies evolution, but chemistry as well. I don't deny chemistry. I think chemistry is essential. It's wonderful. Bill, you're a wonderful Christian. Keep it up. Oh, I don't know if Bill's a Christian or not. I hope so. I debated him once, or maybe twice. I don't remember.
You don't remember? How many of those apricot seeds have you had, Kent?
He's really got a large vocabulary of all these cavemen that he thinks he's ancestor to. They're an ancestor to him. But it doesn't make it true. And he just spouts off these things like, this is ancestor to this, and this is one of our ancestors. No, you don't know any of that stuff. I pointed out to Bill carefully and sweetly, any fossils you find in the dirt, really all you know is it died.
And I responded during our debate and showed exactly why Kent Hovind is wrong.
Vitamin B17, the compound your body breaks down to hydrogen cyanide, which is considered extremely poisonous. Oh no, did anybody die yet in here? The worst part is, the people who are willing to believe people rode dinosaurs are willing to poison themselves. I don't want to poison myself. I don't think I ever have. I ate a seed to an apricot. Calm down. It's going to be okay. I've eaten thousands of them. It's fine, okay? When I got out of prison, I had cancer on my cheek and went for one chemo treatment and said, no, I'm going to take vitamin B17 and seeds, and I did, and it's gone. Okay.
Well, that's pretty vague, Kent. Here's a challenge for you. Tell everyone whether or not you believe that those apricot seeds cured your skin cancer.
Chris, skeptic Chris, Fantastic. Now let's see if he'll debate me. Okay, Chris, anytime. Bill chimes in. Hey, Bill. Pick a narrow topic. Yes, please do. Okay. And try to hold him to it. Oh, I'll stay on it. Okay. He just can't seem to do that, especially when he runs out of his old material. Well, Bill, schedule another one. I want you, Bill, to send me the best single of it. I'll show you in a minute what I want. Okay. It's very simple. Robert, his go-to defense is tax money funding public schools. Well, that is one of the many things we're upset about around here. Not against public schools. I'm against teaching lies. Great video, Bill. There's documented deaths as a direct result. Aaron, let me help you out. First of all, should be there are, not there is. This is a contraction for there is. There is documented deaths. That ain't good English, okay? There are documented deaths. This is not true, but I'm just correcting you, okay? As a direct result of people taking B-17. I'm not aware of any. I know there's a whole lot.
What did you just say, Ken? There's a whole lot of? Shouldn't it be there are a whole lot of?
Documented deaths from people taking vaccines and people taking drugs.
So throw in the anti-vax crap on top of the miracle seeds.
Okay, open debate challenge to all your evolution. And I didn't even get to my questions yet. I'm trying. Okay, this is just a tiny slice of a big folder. Okay. What is the single best piece of scientific evidence that seaweed and humans have a common ancestor? The secret of how life began. Today, life has conquered every square inch of Earth, but when the planet formed, it was a dead rock. So when I tell the truth and say evolutionists believe they came from a rock, they get mad at me and say, we don't believe that. Yes, you do. How many trillions of steps would it take to go from a dot of nothing to thyme plant, for instance, one of the ones I used?
Time.
Come on, Kent. You're going to pick on the way people write something when you can't even pronounce common words?
So my challenge is very simple, and all of you are evolutionists, please call in. Help take me up on this. You believe humans and seaweed have a common ancestor. I would just simply like the single best piece of scientific evidence that anybody should want to believe such a dumb thing. Okay? Open challenge, effective April 16th, 2019. Bill and all you guys on your channel, thank you so much for the comedy hour. If you'd like to have a real debate, give me a call anytime.
Well, I'm not really interested in another debate with you right now, Kent, since I already hit the ball out of the park and I'm batting 1,000. I have challenged your son Eric to a debate along with his friend Russ Miller against old Earth creationist and geologist Ken Wilgemuth and I. Eric and Russ are filming a movie on the Grand Canyon and Noah's Flood, so Ken and I thought it would be a really good idea to debate him on the geology there. So far, Eric hasn't responded. I'd like to look at one last thing here before we wrap this up. I missed this the first time I went through the video, but then this caught my attention.
Okay. Hey, welcome to Pensacola. You just got in at the airport from Hawaii. How long have you been on the airplane? Like 2 or 3 days straight? And all right, get him a chair there, guys. Find a chair for him, okay?
Welcome to Pensacola? Didn't Kent seem a little confused? You know what one of the symptoms of cyanide poisoning is? Did anybody pay attention to how many of those seeds he ate?
Folks, Kent Hovind here and the crew at Dinosaur Adventureland in the roaring metropolis of Lenox, Alabama.